Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making baked picnic ham, and that's for Easter. And you know that I made recently a raisin sauce to go with ham, and that's for this ham, or you might use it with another ham if you choose. I want to show you what I have here. I keep calling it ham, but it's actually a picnic ham because it's a shoulder. It's smoked pork shoulder picnic. So if you see something like that, then that's what I'm making. This is uncooked, so I do have to make sure that I cook it long enough for it to be done. And what that involves in this case is placing it in a roasting pan, and you may put a glaze in it or not, or on it. But you'll need to let it cook for about 3 hours. This is about 8.5 pounds. So with that in mind, that size of picnic will take about 3 hours. So what I'm going to do next is to get this vacuum package off the outside, and I'll just lean it here and use some kitchen shears and eventually open this to the point where you can get the picnic shoulder out. And there may be packing material that you do not want to bring along with it. And when you lift this out and put it in your roasting pan, here is the skin side, which you can see, that goes down. And there is netting on this to keep it together. You leave that on. That can be cut off at the end. Now my hands are kind of dirty, so I'm going to wash those and come back and make a glaze. Now that we've placed our ham in our roasting pan, we're going to make a little sauce here. And that is composed of 2 cups of light brown sugar, firmly packed. And then we have water that we're adding. This is 2 cups of water. We'll mix this up in just a minute. We also have vinegar. This is 1 cup of white vinegar. And the last item of our glaze is Coca-Cola. This actually is 13 ounces, and that's because my recipe dates back to when they asked for 2 small Cokes, each of which is 6.5 ounces, and I don't think they make those anymore. Most of us buy 2 liters or something a little larger than that, so I just poured out of a 2 liter from a sugared Coke 13 ounces. Now we're going to stir this together. And it should stir very easily because your brown sugar will immediately dissolve into the rest. And then just pour it over the ham. It does not all have to go on the top, but that's an easy way to get it to all parts of the pan because it's going to go around the front side and the back side and underneath a little bit. I'll lift it and make sure that it goes underneath. It looks really good. Actually, the flavor will go into the ham as it bakes, but during the last hour of baking, I'm going to lift the lid on the roasting pan, and then I'll use a big spoon like this and just dip the glaze up and over and baste it every 15 minutes or so. So it's ready for the oven. We need to put a lid on, a lid that fits. If you don't have a lid that fits your roasting pan, you may use aluminum foil. And then put this a little below the center and remove the upper rack because this takes up so much space. Put it in a 350 degree oven and it will bake for about 3 hours and then we'll be back. Our picnic ham has baked for 3 hours at 350 degrees. And for the last hour, every 15 minutes, I have used this big spoon right here, excuse me, and I have dipped the glaze over the top just so it can get more flavor on the exposed area up here. But it is within a closed pan, so that helps it to get a lot of the flavor anyway reserved. What we're going to do next is bring this out to a cutting board, and then you see our netting is still on there. So I'll have to take a shears or a knife or something and just cut through that and get that off. And then after that, I'm going to use aluminum foil. and I will tent it for about 5 minutes and let it rest. Then I'll be back to slice off some for you. Our tented picnic ham has sat for about 5 minutes under this aluminum foil, and it's just loosely tented. You don't have to make it tight, but that allows the juices to redistribute, makes it very tender. And now I'm going to examine the ham, and I notice that the grain is running in this direction at this point. So if I do a cut like this, that would be cutting across or against the grain. So I'm going to hold on to it with this fork and just slice down like this to show you what a small slice would look like. And it's kind of tangled up there. But I'll put that on this serving platter, and I will be coming back and getting more. I notice down here the grain is going this way, so I think slicing like this will be fine. And these are tiny pieces because they're at the edge. They will get larger as we get toward the center. But this is so tender. It's so easy to cut like that. It just happens to be in small pieces right now. Sorry about that. So I think I'll take a break from the video and go back and get some carved off for you. Here I have a few slices of our Easter picnic ham. And you can see that I put it on a platter, and I put a few golden raisins here at the end. And then I have some fresh mint from our herb garden. And you can see it's very tiny. That's because it's only been out of the ground probably for less than a week. It's just getting going, but I wanted to put it on there anyway. The raisins are here because we made a delicious raisin sauce, which is right here, that is to be served with the ham for those people who like it. It tastes really great, I'll have to say that. Now I'm just going to take a piece or two over to my plate. I like the ones that have the edges that are browned up like that. I'm going to put some raisin sauce on part of that. I want to show you what the texture of the ham is by using a steak knife. You see it's just really tender, pull apart tender. And I will take this crusty piece and dip it into the raisin sauce. Get a little bit there, and we'll try the combination. Mmm, so good. I will have to say that the ham really completes the taste, because in the raisin sauce, we had brown sugar and also the raisins that were sweet. And then we added some prepared mustard and some vinegar, so that kind of put some sourness in, some tartness. But then when you add the ham, that's the salty flavor. So everything that you could possibly want for one dish is here. And I hope you enjoy this. This is going to be our last video before Easter, so I want to wish all of you a wonderful Easter.